let us discuss regarding IC engines today. First, definition of engine let be given. So what is engine? So engine, normally you know, it is been a part of a vehicle mainly used to drive the vehicle. So as vehicle to drive, the power should be generated. That main power generation takes place in a part called IC engine. So as power in turn heat it is generated, that can be converted into mechanical work. We call that as IC engine, or normally heat engines. We call it as all engines as heat engines, because why we call engines as heat engines? Because whatever the devices that generate a heat and produces a work, that is called as an heat engine. Now, can we call IC engine as a heat engine? Yes, we can call IC engine as a heat engine, because the internal combustion engine as a fuel in the cylinder, that combustion occurs. Due to that combustion, large amount of or enormous amount of heat it is developed. This heat in term of power or in term of pressure being utilized by the vehicle to drive or to move from one part to another part, this is called as an heat engine. As mainly the base or mainly variable part in this is a heat. So as it is a heat is generated, power is generated, the vehicle is driven. So that's why we call internal combustion engine also as an IC heat engines. So first, that's why the definition of heat engine is given over here. So what is heat engine? The device which transforms the chemical energy of the fuel into thermal energy. What is chemical energy? Chemical energy, where we have present? Yes, hydrocarbon fuels, we call it as. All fuels are hydrocarbon fuel. So we call this hydrocarbon fuel as chemical energy. It contains a chemical energy. How this chemical energy is utilized? By burning. So once we burn, the heat is generated. So while the heat, what it is generated, that we call it as a thermal energy. Yes, chemical energy of the fuel is converted into thermal energy. This thermal energy uses to produce a mechanical work. Now heat which is produced inside in a cylinder, that have a pressure, that pressure works on the piston. This piston absorbs that pressure and start reciprocating. This reciprocation motion is a mechanical work. So there is a conversion of energies, like chemical energy of the fuel is converted into thermal energy. Thermal energy of the fuel is utilized and produced a mechanical work. This is called as an heat energy, heat engine. So mainly three types of energies combined together to give a movement for a vehicle, and that type of engines are called as an heat engines. Chemical energy of the fuel converted into thermal energy by burning or by combustion. Next, thermal energy is utilized to convert a mechanical work. So finally, this is called as a heat engine. Now, heat engines, we have mainly two types. One is external combustion engine and other one is internal combustion engine. So what is external combustion engine? So external combustion engine, as you all know, the name itself indicates external. So external means the combustion of for that engine occurs outside the engine. That is called external combustion engine. What examples we can take? Steam engine, steam turbine, Stirling engine, etc. How we can give a steam engine as example for external combustion engine? You take a steam engine, the steam cannot be produced inside an engine, or the steam cannot converted, water cannot be converted into a steam inside an engine. The steam should be converted. Steam is itself is a energy. So steam, which is not a fuel, steam itself is a energy to directly converting into work. Where the steam is produced? The steam cannot be produced inside an engine. Instead of that, the water in the boiler is converted into steam outside the engine. This steam is utilized by the engine and that engine runs. So like this way, we give an example for external combustion engine or EC engine. So where a combustion of a fuel takes place outside the engine is called as external combustion engine. So, and one more example, we can take steam turbine. Yes, we can call the turbine also an engine, because there is also a production of power. There is also a production of a mechanical work. So meanwhile, we call that as an also engine. And as it is using a steam, that steam it is produced externally or outside the turbine. So we call it as external combustion engine. Like that, we have a Stirling engine, where we have a fuel in the Stirling engine. Outside combustion occurs, the heat which is generated, that is transmitted to the cylinder, so that the work condition takes place. So this is are the examples for external combustion engine. Next, we have one more type of engine we call internal combustion engine. What is internal combustion engine? As you all know, external combustion engine, the fuel combustion occurs outside the engine. Internal combustion engine, the fuel combustion occurs internally inside the cylinder of the engine. It is called internal combustion engine. So what are the examples? Now, whatever the vehicles we have that uses a petrol as a fuel, that uses a diesel as a fuel, that uses a gas as a fuel, all this type of engine where inside the cylinder combustion occurs, in combustion releases an heat energy. So we call this as internal combustion engines. These are main two types of engines we have that is classified from heat engines, external combustion and as well as internal combustion engines. Now in this topic, as related to internal combustion engine, we will study. We will go for AC engines or external combustion engine. Related to internal combustion engine, it may be a petrol, it may be a gas, or it may be a diesel engine. Related to that, we will study regarding the testing, performance, analysis, heat balance sheet of the IC engine. So what we will study in IC engine? IC engine mainly related to testing of an IC engine, performance calculator of an IC engine, maintenance of an IC engine, and as well as heat balance sheet of an IC engine. So these four topics we will cover up, and the problems on each four topics will be solved over here. So before going to the main topics, let us discuss some terminology of engine. So basic terminology. So when we come across with basic engine terminology, the main part in engine is a cylinder, because combustion of fuel occurs inside the cylinder. The piston start moving by absorbing a power or pressure generated inside the cylinder. So that is called mechanical work. So everything occurs is inside the cylinder. So we consider a engine cylinder. For that, we give some terminologies or specifications. So what are those basic engine terminologies? Let us see it now. So these are the two types of engines. On that engines, we have internal combustion engine. And in the internal combustion engine, we will give a terminologies basically, especially for cylinder, because the main part of an engine is a cylinder where all the process occurs, heat is generated, power is generated. So let us study the engine terminology with the small diagram of cylinder. Please write down this diagram. Write down that diagram where we consider a cylinder. External diameter, we call it as a bore, and the piston at two positions. One is top dead center, TDC we call, piston at bottom dead center, BDC we call, and the distance between that is called in a stroke. Or if the piston start traveling from BDC to TDC, the length it is covered is called as in a stroke. Next, the piston to above the cylinder head, there will be a certain clearance, that we call it as in a clearance volume, and outside the outline is called as in a cylinder. So if they ask basic engine terminologies, the main part is an engine cylinder. Please write down that engine cylinder, and that covers all the terminologies of the engine. Please note down this diagram, take some time and complete it. Some time, write down this stroke, length, ella porkoli one nimsha. Yes, from here you write down. TDC and BDC you have written, I think, topmost position and bottommost position. Bore, it is refers to the diameter of engine cylinder. Stroke length, it is the distance traveled. See, what is the difference between swept volume and stroke length? Swept volume is the amount of volume consumed. Stroke is nothing but the distance traveled. So in terms of length we discussed, then that is a stroke. In terms of meter cube if we discuss, then that is a swept volume. So both are same. If I want to show the swept volume, I have to write the swept volume here only, but in terms of volume I will define. If I want to show the stroke, I have to show it the stroke here only, but in terms of length we will talk. So that's why you should be careful in terms of stroke length and as well as swept volume. If it meter cubes, then it is a swept volume. If it is a meter, then it is a stroke. Please write down this up to here. So we have written. Let us see this clearance volume, sweat volume in the video of which has been shown.
Why, जब से see पूरे कितने ऑनलाइन क्लास हुए, जो भी डेट के साथ लिखो दर, right?
Okay, you can observe the clearance volume. What it has been shown over here, and that is in this diagram. Don't definitely define this compression ratio as it is in the screen. So it is total volume of the cylinder to the clearance volume. Adengi, everybody, you tell me please in terms of how you have understood. What is compression ratio? What is the requirement? What is the use of compression ratio? You can unmute yourself and tell me.
The amount compression. Of compression taken place in the clearance volume, sir, the piston. From the combustion.
So amount of combustion, compression.
Yes, sir. Combustion taken. That's when it compresses, low, sir.
Yes, yes. The amount of compression occurring in.
In the clearance volume.
Yes, exactly, sir. The amount of compression occur inside the cylinder. That in terms of ratios or that in terms of value we get, that we call it as compression ratio. Yes, that depends upon different engines. If I talk about petrol engine, compression ratio usually it is less. If I talk about diesel engine, the compression ratio usually more. Why in the diesel engine more? Why in the petrol engine more? Because petrol engine always contains a spark plug or igniter. We call it as an igniter. Igniter will not leave the piston to compress more and the fuel to get ignited. The igniter, what it does, it produces a spark. That spark comes in contact with the fuel, itself gets ignited before completing the compression. So that's why we consider compression ratio, or we have compression ratio for petrol engines less. Next, for diesel engines, as we doesn't have a spark plug or an igniter, the compression occurring will be more. Due to this compression, or due to the compression, the pressure developed inside the fuel will be more. And that pressure have a rubbing between the molecules, creating the friction and heat and liberating combustion. So this combustion can be occurred only by compression. So compression ratio will be more for diesel engines.